Deezy, Double Easy, another episode all about semis. How about you out there, drivers? Man, start of a new week. I'm a little tired, just getting up. Gonna be rolling back out about 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock. Got a Amazon load actually picking up in Maryland. Going to Charlotte and then back to Virginia, just right around 600 miles, just at about $1.95 a mile. So I'm going to take that, which brings me back to that cost. So as you guys, I'm going to start do a video on that one, and I want to go ahead and get it popping. So let's get to it. So how do you know when you have a good rate per mile? Is that rate per mile good for you, or is it just cheap freight? So there's a lot of answers to that question. There's a lot of rights and there's a lot of wrongs. And basically, it's always going to boil down to each individual's needs. That's the meat and potato of it. But how do you know? And I'm going to break that down for you. But everybody's numbers are going to be different. And this is interesting because a lot of times we hear people saying, oh, he's pulling cheap freight or she's pulling cheap freight. And is it cheap freight or is it cheap freight for you? And don't get me wrong, there is some cheap freight. I mean, I'm seeing stuff on the board, 35 cents and 25 cents and, you know, a mile. Like, I'm seeing it, you know, to the point where you almost think, like, that must be a typo type of thing, right? But, yeah, I'm speaking more to the dollar and change up, okay? Dollar and change up is what I'm speaking to, because that's kind of where this baseline is going to be going. And I just don't think nobody should be running no cents on the dollar. Like, no, literally, you running a whole load for 35 cents. That's some company stuff there, and even with that, that's still cheap. But nonetheless, you know, companies can do that, especially if they're paying their drivers a very generous hourly wage, then it balances out. But that's a whole nother conversation. How do you know, right? How many times have I done videos on telling you guys about knowing your truck costs? How do you know that? Again, I'm going to break that down for you, because again, I'm going to assume that some people just don't know. And if you're out there running your truck like that and just spinning the wheels and you really don't know, then here's a good time to start knowing, because this is what puts a lot of people in bad situations. So I'm going to jump right into this to let you guys know. When your truck is paid for, you can afford a different rate, right, than somebody whose truck's not paid for. Everybody's truck payments are going to be different. Everybody's equipment payments are going to be different, meaning trailer prices and things like that, or if they're leasing their trailers or whatever you guys are doing with your trailers. All that equipment price is going to be different. Hence, everybody's rate per mile is going to be different to what they need. But you need to know what that is, and you need to know the numbers that make sense to put in there. A lot of people are putting all their cost into the rate per mile, and they're like, I need $3 a mile, or I need a minimum of $2.50 or $2, whatever it is, and that might not even be the reality, because you need to know what is costing you to do that load per mile, what your cost is to operate the truck. Simple terms, what is it that costs you to operate that truck per mile? So to start out, to give you guys an example, I'm going to give you mine and show you how I break it down. I'm not going to do the whole mirror screen thing and all that. I'm going to tell you the numbers, and you guys can figure out how to do your own from there. I just don't have the capacity or the energy to even, you know, start trying to do screens. And I just don't want to do all that editing on this video right now. I'm just being honest with you guys. But you should be able to get this. So, my cost, I know, is a minimum of right at $1.15 to $1.25. Now, you have what I call a actual number and a realistic number. My realistic number right now in this rate and what the fuel prices are, my realistic rate, I mean, my actual rate is actually just slightly under $1.15, you know, almost a dollar if fuel prices keep dropping. But I stay at my $1.15 to $1.25. For the sake of the video, I know my cost is $1.15. Now, what does that include? That includes what it costs me fuel wise and insurance. Those are the main two things I need to run this truck, right? Can't run it without insurance. No, darn sure can't run it without fuel. So that's the first thing that I include in that rate. Everything else, my pay, you know, maintenance, that's going to come out of everything else. So right there off the bat, I know what my numbers are. How did I come up with that number? Well, you figure out what your average miles are per week, and you figure out what that equals out to per month, and then you break it down from there. So, for instance, okay, we all know the average, a lot of people, you know, when you, especially when you company, average miles is, oh, they say they'll give you 3,000 miles, right? 3,000 is the magic number. Well, most owner operators don't really want to run $3,000 miles a week. You just don't want to do that. That's why you become an owner operator, right? To kind of buy back your time so you can make less, you know, less miles, more money. But sometimes you got to run 3,000. So for the sake of the video, we're going to say between the 2,000 and 3,000 miles. But we're going to go with my number at two. My number is roughly about 2,200 miles. This is where I like to be for a week. So now I know that we're saying I'm at 2,000. So I got 2,000. If I times 2,000, times four, that's giving me 8,000, right? That's 8,000. But for the sake of the video, we're going to go with a 3,000, okay? We're going to go with a 3,000. So I say my miles is 3,000 miles a week. And I do it high, right? So we're going to say that's 3,000. That's 12,000, right, for the month. But let's back up a little bit and break down the actual rate per mile far as fuel is concerned. You need to know what your truck is running. You need to know what your truck is actually running per mile to have a good number of what your fuel should be per mile. So in my case, I use the average. The average is about 5.5 on average. When you're dealing with dispatchers and things like that, they usually base that off the national average of truck, 5.5. But we all know most newer trucks, we're getting 7 miles to the gallon, 6.5. I'm in that 6.5 bracket. Some guys are getting 8 consistently. If you use your actual, what you think it is, you might run into problems, because the minute you get a heavy load or you run a week worth of heavy loads and you realize you spent $400 more in fuel than you usually do, and you're thinking something's wrong with the truck, it's just because you put your numbers too high. So I start with the lower number because that's going to make your fuel cost higher. If you save, who cares? That's money in the pocket, right? Hope y'all following me. So I use 5.5, right? 5.5. Now, if fuel, I use my number, fuel had been averaging $5 a gallon. So that's what I'm using, right? $5 a gallon. And you divide the cost by the mileage. So if we divide $5 by the 5.5, that's going to give us 90 cents, right? So, and that's exactly what I use. So my cost is 90 cents per mile. So I have to go 5 miles will give me my $5 for my gallon of fuel. Simple math right there. So now I know I'm 90 cents for fuel. I put my insurance roughly at $2,000 a month. So now I know that I'm at $2,000 a month for fuel, I mean for my insurance. Now this is where it gets a little tricky. So now we know we at 2,000 miles a week. So we're at 2,000 miles, 2,000 miles, gosh guys, I'm sorry. 3,000 miles, because my numbers is actually that, so I'm making them higher, and I gotta keep remembering that I said that for you guys. So we know our insurance is 2,000, and we're saying that we're running 3,000 miles a week, which is basically 12,000 miles a month. So if we divide that 12,000 by our cost, which is the 2,000, that's going to give us we divide our 2,000 divided by 12,000, right? That should give us in the ballpark of 16 cents. So now we got 15 cents, well, 16 cents. Sake of the video, we're going to say 15. So we got 15 cents. Plus what? Our 90 cents. There we go. 0.90. And that gives us exactly $1.05. So that's your fuel. And that is your insurance. Provided you're running a full month, that's where you need to be at. So theoretically, that is where my base is. Now I can add 10 cents for to that. I can say, all right, I want to add another 5 cents or 10 cents per mile for maintenance, right? So if I add 10 cents to that, which is what I do, I get my $1.15 that I told you guys about, because I like to add it sometimes. So I'll put the 10 cent in there, boom, we got $1.15. Now I can choose to take the $1.15 right out of the rate per mile, or I can take it out at the back end. Now with that being said, that is my bottom number. So I could literally run the truck, might not make no profit, but I could run the truck. Just to run a truck, I need $1.15, actually $1.05. Now it's actually a little bit lower now because fuel has been down, and fuel's been down in the low threes. So I'm really over the edge now. But am I over the edge when I'm still in the dollars and rates are looking like dollar something? So I really don't really need to do much of any adjustment for me. And I just don't see it. If the fuel prices were down really dramatically, then I'll go back and revisit and bring the numbers down. But right now I'm comfortable at that $1.15, because now when I see a load, so let's sit there and say, case in point, I told you guys I'm on an Amazon load right now that's $1.94, right? So I'm at $1.94 on this load, and if I minus my cost, which we know is $1.15, I'm making 80 cents a mile to the truck. So now First off, there's still company drivers that's not even making that. And that's what we got to look at right now for our owner operator guys, that equipment's paid or have low cost on their equipment, right? A lot of guys are not making 80 cents a mile. They're just not making it. So I'm at 80 cents a mile. This load, let's say, is, we're going to do the mile. So a 79, we're just going to say 79 cents. This calculator that I'm using, guys, I hate it. Times, I think the miles was 690. So to the truck, we'll just be roughly, because the load was paying about 13 and some change, right? 545 to the truck. But the actual rate, right? The actual rate, the actual rate, guys, I'm sorry, I'm trying to multitask. I might have to switch my calculator because I don't like this. The actual rate is, I was right, I was not, it was six, it's about 690. Three, so the actual rate was 13,338. So that's what we made total. To the truck, sake of conversation, 540 something to the truck, right? But we know that it might not cost me, because theoretically I can just, now that I know what my fuel cost is, I'm saying 90 cents, right? Saying it's 90 cents times the miles, which was, we said 690, is saying that it's going to be $621, right, on the fuel. More than likely, it's not going to be that much, because I'm not going to pay $5 for the fuel. I'm probably going to pay closer to about, you know, 380 to 4, because I was looking on my mud flap to see that, to counterbalance that. So, which brings me back to, don't get so caught up in the fuel with those numbers, because that residue money is going to go back to my pocket, right? And that's how I pretty much look at that. Now, for you guys that's got payments, right? I'm gonna switch the calculator up, because I don't like this thing. I'm using that one on my iPad, man, and it sucks for the one that I have, right? Now, for you guys that are got payments, now let's watch this magic here, right? We know that my cost was $1.15, but it was really 105, but say good conversation, $1.15. That was the fuel, the maintenance for the 10 cents, and the insurance, right? Simply speaking. Now, but actually I left out the 10 cent, because I said if I add the, on the 105, it would have been 115. But since we're making it higher, we're gonna say that we're just gonna say, for the sake of this part here, we're just gonna say the $1.15 is the fuel and the insurance. So now, if you're a guy that has a $1,500 truck payment, that's gonna work out to be just another, we're gonna use the higher number. We're gonna say if your truck payment is $2,000, right? We go a little high. That's gonna put you right back at the 15 cents. If you're running 3,000 miles a week, 12,000 miles, it's gonna put you at another 15 cents. So let's add the 15 cents, right? That's just gonna put us at $1.30. So your truck payment, your fuel, and your insurance, if you are running your own authority, is going to be $1.30 at those numbers, right? Now, most of us are getting $2 mile lows. Most of us are getting